What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com. Hope you guys have watched the previous video and are ready to participate in the giveaway which I'm going to conduct very soon. If you haven't, then don't worry, you still have a chance. Watch the last video and follow the instruction to ensure your participation. Link is in the description. Anyways, let's come to our today's tutorial. Today we will see how we can make a complete synchronized backup copy of a table. By synchronized backup copy, I mean the backup table gets automatically populated or updated with the main table simultaneously. Let's see how we can achieve this. As it's apparently clear that for the demonstration, we will require two identical tables. One which will serve as your main table that will accept the data from your database user, and the second which will be your backup table. I will use the superheroes table which we have been using since the beginning of this DML trigger series as our main table. This table only has one column with the name sh_name, and here you can see the structure of this table. Next, we will have to create an identical table to this one which will work as our backup table. Let's create this backup table. This particular create table as command will create the table with the name superheroes_backup, which will have the identical structure as of the table which you have specified in the select statement, which is superheroes in our case. In order to better understand the create table as command, please read my blog on the same, link is in the description. Let's execute. Table created. So as of now, we have our both main as well as backup table. Next, we have to write the trigger which will insert, update or delete the rows from the backup table when someone does the same with our main table. Let's do it. But before that, let's close this script output and clear the screen. Great. Here is our trigger. As you can see, the name of this trigger is sh_backup, and this will execute for each and every row before insert, delete or update DML statement on the main table superheroes. As we have set the status of this trigger enable, which means it will start performing its work as soon as we execute and compile it. Now let's come to the working part of this trigger and see what's happening. Here we have the execution section. Inside this we have if then else if statement. This statement has three conditions, each for their respective DMLs: insert, delete or update. These conditions are set to be true when their respective DMLs will be executed over underlying superheroes table. For example, if a user executes an insert statement on main table superheroes, then first if condition will set to be true and respective DML will insert a value into the backup table superheroes_backup, and sudo record new will make sure that the value will be the one which is currently inserted into the main table, as sudo record new allows you to access a row currently being processed. Similarly, in case a delete statement is executed over main table, then second if condition will set to be true and respective delete DML will delete the row from the backup table. In this case, sudo record old will make sure that the value which is deleted in the backup table is the same one which was currently deleted in the main table. And in case of update DML, third if condition will set to be true and respective update DML will update the record in the backup table. Using sudo record new, we are fetching the new updated value from the main table and replacing the old value which was specified using sudo record old. The working of sudo records has been explained in detail in the previous video, so I would suggest you to watch it for a better understanding, or you can read about the same on my blog. Now let's test this trigger by writing DMLs on our main table superheroes. Before that, let me show you that both main and backup tables are empty and contain no rows. Zero rows return. zero rows return again, which indicates both the tables are empty. As it's confirmed that both the tables are empty, so now move ahead and test the trigger. But before that, let's execute and compile the trigger first. Trigger compiled successfully. Now let's insert a row into the main table superheroes. One row inserted, let's insert one more row. Okay, so now we have two rows in our main table. Check both the tables once again and ensure the success of the insert DML we just executed. We have two rows in main table superheroes. That's great. Now check the backup table. Amazing. Both the rows exist into our backup table too, which means trigger is working for insert DML. Now let's check update statement too. So row updated successfully. Let's check the main table. Here the value Iron Man replaced the old value Batman. Let's quickly check the backup table too. Great, changes got reflected here too. Now delete the Superman record from the main table. One row deleted. Let's quickly check the main table. No Superman record. Now check the status of backup table. No Superman record here too. That shows we have successfully created a trigger which is backing up our main table superheroes. Though you can write this trigger for any table, but I would not advise you to use such triggers on those tables that involves heavy data input, deletion and updation. This is chiefly due to the performance reasons, though it will work fine but could slow down your query processing. Anyways, you can find this code with more details on my blog, link is in the description. Make sure to subscribe as I am going to reveal the giveaway product very soon. You can also follow me on my social for regular updates. That's all for today. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. Also, you can support us by sharing this video on your social or by any means you find convenient. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.